Georgia Hale come off the bench. I think she'll make a huge impact on the side this afternoon.
Before we get to our commentators, I'll get a pre-game prediction from you both. Sam?
Oh, I'm going to go with the Roosters today.
I think the Titans can have their first win this afternoon. That's mine.
Evenly split. Love to see it. It's time for kickoff. Let's head to Wynn Stadium now and join our commentators. Here is Steve Blocker-Roach and Ben Homer.
Thanks, Honor. Welcome back to Wollongong as round two of the NRLW continues here on Fox League. It's the Sydney Roosters taking on the Gold Coast Titans. Two teams who went down in the opening round searching for their first win of the season, and for the Titans, their first in club history in this competition. Steve Roach is alongside for the call. Good afternoon to you, Blocker. This one, Chapes, is a fascinating one.
Yeah, Benny boy, looking forward to this one. Unfortunately, the Roosters went down 20 points to 4 last week against the Brisbane Broncos, but I think they can bounce back here this afternoon. I'm really looking forward to the Gold Coast Titans, their first season in the Women's League here. And what I'm looking forward to is Stephanie Hancock. That'll be a big signing for them, so I'm looking forward to seeing her play in these sort of conditions. But there was a lot of offloads in the first game, so the ground looks like it's held up pretty well.
Yes, yeah, Steph Hancock, who turns 40 on Wednesday, veteran of the NRLW competition. Hannah Southwell, a key player at lock for the Roosters.
Yeah, I love a tackling technique. I've seen her over the last couple of seasons, and the way that she gets in front of the opposition, beautiful technique. You could learn a lot from her.
So the first meeting of the Roosters and Titans in the NRLW is underway. Two teams out for their first win of the season. The Roosters with the first use of the football. It's a strong defence straight off the top from Steph Hancock in there with Zara Canfield. On the debutante, Maya Hill Moana in there for the Roosters. Here's Taylor Predibon. Now coming in off the wing is Tafunga. She's going to be put to the turf. 10 metres short of the halfway line. Olivia Higgins in there. At dummy half, here's Predibon. Came so close to her first try in the competition last week against the Broncos. Back it comes for McGregor, halfback today after coming off the bench last week. Taken by Politi.
Yeah, it's a good first set there from the Roosters. Just a little thing too, they need to put a little bit of pressure. McGregor, too much time with that kick downfield. One of the things that you've got to work on in games of footy, putting pressure on the kicker. The Titans with the football now.
Into the arms of Ralph Strand-Smith, who scored on debut last week for the Titans. In that defeat to the Dragons, 20-12, they were actually down 14-0, got it back to 14-12. It was a tight run thing at the end. The Roosters a 20-4 defeat to Brisbane. Of course, the three-time premiers, a tough ask in the first match of the season. Now it's Tasman Gray, the former Rooster. Raleigh Nati with the kick. Tafunga is going to let it roll over the sideline harmlessly in the end. And let's check in downstairs with Nico Paharilio.
Yeah, g'day guys. Conditions down here are actually kind of relatively similar to the dry Sunday we had in Newcastle last week. The threat of heavy rain, but it stayed away so far. Let's hope it remains that way so we can see some free-flowing football here this afternoon.
Yeah, let's hope it does for your sake as well, Nico, down there on the sideline.
We need Shannon, push out, please.
So the Roosters with the play the ball 10 out in the centre after that kick over the sideline from the Titans. Big team news for them is Bree Clark, their goal-kicking front rower, out of this one with a back injury, which meant Steph Hancock came into the starting side and Natu Puna comes onto the bench on debut. Isabel Kelly, the ball spills out to Kelleher, but the referee, Cara Lee Nolan, says it went forward, and this is a great opportunity now for the Titans to go on the attack.
Yeah, just try to get the ball free there, Isabel Kelly. Sprinted onto the football. Ended up a good tackle on the back foot there from Peters, the centre three-quarter there for the Titans. Got on the outside of it, and then she swung it to the ground, loses the footy. Good call there. First mistake from the Roosters in their own half.
Was an issue for them last week. They made a ton of mistakes inviting pressure from the Broncos. And in the end, it sapped them of energy. Grace Griffin feeding the scrum and picked up by Brayley Nati, the hooker, onto the halfback. The partners, Kimiora and Brittany. And here is Brittany. Brayley Nati stepping off the right, straight into the left shoulder of Higgins. Picked up by Brill. Fed Martor. Scored last week for the Titans. Brayley Nati now to Griffin. Looking out the back now for Jasmine Peters. On debut today for the Titans. Missed last week due to that concussion suffered in the All-Stars clash. Brayley Nati onto Hancock. Return the pass. And here is Brill. Darting away from a couple. This is brilliant from Destiny Brill. She's only a couple of metres short. Brayley Nati exploring the short side. Jasmine Peters. Can she reach out and get there? She can. On debut, the 19-year-old opens the scoring for the Gold Coast Titans.
Well, Jasmine Peters is the one that forced the error just up the other end of the field there before the halfway line. And it's the offload of Stephanie Hancock. Just a little bit earlier in that set, she has plenty of things to do here. Steps off the right foot. Great strength shown. Now, there's two or three Roosters around to make that tackle. And on the back of a mistake, the Titans, that'll lift their confidence, are the first to score. Look at that, plenty of work to do. Steps off the right foot, some arm grabbing there. And Peters gets over the stripe early.
She was just hanging over the try line, wasn't she? Finally got the ball down. Played for the Gold Stars in the QRL competition last year. That's the best players from North Queensland, Cairns, Townsville and Mackay. And also part of that Queensland under-19s origin team. And as I said before, missed out in round one because of concussion suffered in that All-Stars clash a few weeks ago. So fantastic to see her back. Was part of that Indigenous All-Stars team.
Well, the great thing is they didn't panic. They were trying to get that repeat set, but they got the try off it in the end. As I said, a beautiful right foot step to get back in field. But Hancock was the one who started all early in the tackle count. A couple of little offloads, little flick out the back, keep the ball alive. So dangerous, especially in these conditions. The ground looks in magnificent shape, doesn't it? So you'd expect with all the rain, it'd be a clogmire, but that's not the case.
Yeah, Zara Canfield stepping up for a first kick in the NRLW. And how about that? One from one. Let's head down to the sideline with Nico.
Yeah, the Titans would be overjoyed with that start, gentlemen. It's actually a really interesting matchup here today, guys. Two sides coming off losses. The Titans, who showed plenty of promise in the second half last week, and the Roosters, full of star power. Never really got into a groove last week, the Roosters. 17 completions from 31 total sets for a rate of 55%. Roosters fans would have to think if their team can just hold on to the ball, the talent on the field will take care of the rest. But easier said than done, of course.
Yeah, thanks, Nico. Yeah, it was a massive issue for the Chooks last week, just their inability to hang on to the ball. Remember, coming up after this one, the Parramatta Reels are in action. They're taking on the home side, the Dragons, taken by Canfield.
Olivia, Olivia!
Who took that kick a moment ago with Bree Clark out of the side after she kicked two from two last week. So they've had a bit of goal-kicking practice this week, the Titans. Karina Brown picks it up from dummy half and straight into a brick wall in the form of Toga Tuki and Higgins. Now Steph Hancock, as we mentioned pre-game, turns 40 on Wednesday, her 13th match in the NRLW. Brayley Nati held in the tackle by Sergis and Kelleher. Brayley Nati at dummy half, and back it comes to Griffin. Righty Parker stationed underneath it, took it comfortably. Good field position start to the set here for the Roosters.
Yeah, so important. That's a great start there. And the kick down field from the Roosters. Parker bringing the football back now. You see the back five getting involved here. Back near the halfway line already, so that's a great start to the set. And there's a penalty. That's even better. They'll kick downfield. They'll end up about 30 metres out straight away in the attack. Well, the tackle penalty there.
They completed the set after scoring points, the Titans, but not a whole lot on the final tackle play. And now the Roosters with a penalty, starting the set on halfway. What can Jess Sergis do at the end of this set in attacking territory? Olivia Koenig has the ball in hand. Scored for the Roosters last week, the only try scorer for them in that match with Brisbane. Kelleher, you can see Kelly into the middle of the park, the left centre. Now feeding the pass to Meeks. And Meeks rode the first tackle. Couldn't get away from the second. Griffin brought her down. And now Predabon. That's strong from Taylor Predabon. Brayley came back to pull her down. Higgins onto Southall. There's so much space out to the right. And Kelleher's pass looked forward to Koenig anyway. And that's such a disappointing end for the Roosters.
Gee, had they gone through the hands there, they would have scored for your life. Just the pass, just a little bit too hard there from the halfback. McGregor, charging run. Just the wrong option there. They hang on the Titans and receive a penalty.
So that will just relieve a bit of the pressure that was building on the Titans.
The pass was a little bit too hard there to Koenig. She was hitting the ball at speed. And as I said, they had the numbers on the outside. Just the wrong option there. Go through the hands, the Roosters would have scored in the corner.
Don't forget, Test cricket continues in 2022. Don't miss a minute of Australia's first Test match against Pakistan, live and exclusive on Fox Cricket. Day three continuing a little later on this afternoon. Togatuki and Predabon lining up on Destiny Brill. Togatuki slow to get back and exploring that space is Brayley Nati. She doesn't have any support though. Bridie Parker with a fantastic tackle, the fullback. Griffin now to Politi. Ran last week for 172 metres, the Titans fullback. Brill. Southwell and Togatuki bring her down. Inside the 20 here, the Titans on the final play. Griffin. It's angling towards the corner and Karina Brown gets there for the Gold Coast Titans. And in her 12th match in the NRLW, finally has her first try.
You can put it down to Nati, the break that she made in the middle third of the field there. As we said, there was no support, but they really struggled to scramble back to get in position. They go up the short side here, the grubber kick in and behind. Well weighted. She kicked the ball on the outside of her foot. That was deliberate there. That's a sensational kick. Great chase through by Katrina Brown. And she scores the try. Just have a look how flat-footed they were. They couldn't get across. Kick off the side of the boot. That's brilliant play. Deliberate. And the second try to the Titans.
The former Rooster scoring her first NRLW try. Can you believe that, Blocker? Four tries in Origin, eight tries for the Gillaroos. And now her first try in her 12th match in the NRLW. It's taken a while.
Well, that's the big thing. The ball was put into space on the ground, but it was kicked off the side of the boot. Chase that ball as hard as you can. And that's the sort of result you'll get from it. What a start from the Titans coming into this game. Everyone was talking about the Roosters. Been a great start. They've completed well. On the back of a penalty, got down the other end of the field, and then also that run from Nati out of dummy half. The support wasn't there, but they finished it off beautifully.
So Zara Canfield has had a couple of difficult attempts to start her goal-kicking career in the NRLW. How does she go from a metre in from the sideline? It's a good strike, but it's going to fade across goal. Let's check in with Nico.
Yeah, Karina Brown, someone very familiar with the Roosters. She played 7 games for the Tricolours in between 2018 and 19. She's a Gold Coast girl, so she was actually the Queensland number one for a long time, now still playing for the Maroons on the wing. 2013 and 2017 World Cup winner with the Gillaroos as well. And she actually turns 33 in 3 days, so celebrating with a try is Karina Brown.
Thanks, Nico. So the Roosters, with an early setback, they have the task ahead of them now as the Dragons head into Wynn Stadium in Wollongong. Home side, as the Roosters put in a very short kickoff, and it's a solid hit from Yasmin Meeks on the try scorer, Karina Brown. I should say it was actually Canfield who brought it back. That is brilliant defence. And now it's Jasmine Peters who scored the opening try for the Gold Coast Titans. Both tries coming down their right edge. Hancock gets the offload away to Brill.
She's been good, Brill, hasn't she? I don't know if that's the right tactics here. We saw the replay, the early kickoff, and real short. I'd be playing for field position if I was the Roosters. They're up 40 metres out now, and they're on the fly, the Titans.
Politi with the early kick. Spilled, it looked to be by Meeks. Looked to be a knock-on, and there was.
I think it's a fair call, too.
And the Titans are going to get another set here.
Something a little bit different there from the Titans. Kick early in the tackle count. Griffin it was, too. She set up the last try, that beautiful kick. Come up the short side again. Three players laying in and around the play the ball. There's the grubber kick in and behind. There's the knock-on. The Titans are playing that well with confidence. Hard to stop here.
Well, last week everyone was talking about the Roosters' defence in that first half effort against Brisbane. They held them out. Once again, they're being forced to defend. Today, they've conceded 2 early tries, though, and this is a massive defensive set. They can't afford to be down 14 or potentially 16-0. Well, they've been given a let-off there, spilled by Shannon Martor. And could that just swing the momentum?
Gee, it's a big thing when you get those sort of opportunities and you get a repeat set after you've scored. Just got to concentrate on holding that football. As I said, the conditions aren't that bad here. Not that slippery. Ground's in great condition. The Titans let one go there.
Hannah Southwell puts the bit between her teeth and charges forward. And already the Roosters with Keely Joseph out there and was getting perilously close to a lifting tackle on Hill Moana. Maisie McGregor across to Sergis. Not allowed much space there by the Titans' left edge. Maisie McGregor with a cross field kick. It's going to run away from Karina Brown. It's a fantastic kick in the end from McGregor. Exactly what the Roosters needed. Again, Southwell, well, she came in to make the tackle and Politi just bounced away. Lauren Dam. So, the perfect start for the Gold Coast Titans in their second match in the NRLW. Looking for their first win in the competition. Leading at 10-0 early on. Brayley Nati now to Brill. Puts it under her arm. And it will be the final play now for the Gold Coast. Grace Griffin gets some height on the kick. It's swirling there for Bridie Parker. Solid take on a 10 and gets it up over the 20. That's a good return from the Roosters fullback.
Yeah, it certainly is. But the chase from the Titans have got to be a little bit better than that. It was a nice take. Just improved the position there with a 20-metre run downfield. So important to kick chase. You lead 10-0, you start dropping off. All those tough things that you still got to do. Sure, they'll talk about that at halftime. Although they're leading 10 points to nil, you've got to kick chase so strongly.
Higgins picked it up and found Meeks, who was trying to explore that space behind the ruck. And she did. And a bit of a headlock there. Isabel Kelly is down. Just feeling her back. She has had some injury issues in seasons gone by. McGregor. Now into the arms of Koenig. Final tackle now for the Roosters. The option from McGregor is to dribble it down in towards the corner. Politi almost with a juggle. She's got to be careful here, Ivania Politi. She's driven over the sideline. The ball came free. What's the decision?
Exactly what I was talking about a little bit before is that the kick chase down the short side like that. Politi, the fullback there for the Gold Coast Titans. There's the injury. Some fair crunching tackles going on at the moment. Looks like she might have picked up a little bit of a rib injury there. Just wonder. Isabel Kelly. Gee, that's great defence too. You see straight away how the Roosters, she didn't have much work, much room to work in there. Paletti just held up and then forced in the touch. This could be the turning point of the first half here for the Roosters. They'll get the football back now. If they can score, it's game on.
Well, the good news is Isabel Kelly's all good to go. She's into the back line. They're going to go to the short side with Sergis, who puts it down. Yeah, Achilles heel at the moment rears its ugly head again. Another drop ball for the Roosters.
Yeah, it's just can't hang on to the football, can they? They've come out expecting just to go through the motions. Lost the ball at least four occasions so far in this game, just gifting the Titans the ball and also the field position. So got to fix that up. They'll be bitterly disappointed in what's happened early in this game.
So there is the Titans debutant, April Natupuna, in 19 out there. The 18-year-old Queensland under-19's representative, Griffin. Now Politi with a cutout pass to Brown. There wasn't enough space for her to tiptoe down the sideline, so takes the tackle infield. Final one for the Titans. Griffin's kick is looking out on the full and is. So the Titans just struggling with their final tackle plays at the moment and just inviting the Roosters to get back into this one.
You've got to put it down to a good chase there to put pressure on the kicker in Griffin. She had to rush the kick that time. Turn the ball away and around on the halfway line. You've got to get to your kick. The turnover now to the Roosters, back on the attack. Both sides really guilty of not getting to their kicks. The Roosters with another chance here. They've got no problem getting up the other end of the field. Just dropping the ball when they do get up there.
Keely Joseph gets swung around. The interchange player for the Roosters ran over 100 metres last week, so you can see why John Strange wanted her out there. Space out wide for Tafunga. Pulled down by Rastrand Smith and also Lauren Dam. Kelly now to Koenig. Now here is Kapani. Just come onto the field. Her first touch, her first run is a superb one. Burton there at dummy half. Now Koenig. Here's Sergis out to the winger. And Lianne Tafunga grabs her first in the NRLW in just her second match.
Yeah, that was great to watch too. Kapani it was who made that surge right through the middle. She's only been on the field a short time. Here's the run to set it all up. Tafunga, quick play the ball. She's unlucky not to get a penalty there. There's that middle third run again. Catch and pass. They've had the numbers there a couple of times on their right-hand side. And the girl who started it all, Tafunga, gets over the stripe. Showing their class there, the Roosters. If they can hang on to the football, they can score some points. That's their first try.
Scored a bucket load for Cronulla last year in the New South Wales Women's Premiership. 11 in 11. Grabbed 5 in one match. So that's the kind of form she had in 2021. Bringing that into this NRLW season. And wonderful centre play, isn't it, from Jess Sergis?
Well, she showed
catch and pass.
She showed her experience, didn't she? The catch and pass. They obviously know that they've got a fair bit of strike there on their right-hand side. But it was the charge from the replacement, Kapani, that set it all up. And just got done for numbers there. They love scoring. But from a few errors in this game, it's been a nice open game of footy. We've enjoyed it so far.
So Hannah Southwell, she didn't kick last week for the Roosters. It was Jocelyn Kelleher that took the attempt from close range and missed. So maybe she's lost the kicking license. Hannah Southwell's picked it up. And she's been given an almighty assignment here. It's fading back.
Oh, come on.
What a kick from the lock, Hannah Southwell. She can do it all.
That's like shelling peas. You're kidding. You're trying to put the mock on her. What a kick. Here's the replay again. Get him for numbers. Catch and pass. Beautiful stuff. The Roosters are in. First time they've really held the ball down this end, and they've scored. Look at that. How sweet it is.
Absolutely beautiful. I can tell you what's also beautiful. NRL 360, it's back on Monday, March 7. Join new host Braithen Astor alongside Paul Kent to discuss the weekly drama in the world of rugby league. And Blocker at times as well. You'll be on there.
I think I'm on a rotation panel. I'm on, so every 3 weeks you'll get to see me, I suppose, Ben, if you tune in. I'm sure you'll tune in, won't you?
I will. There's an issue here for the Roosters now. Well, here's the kick from Southwell. Why not just show it on replay? Absolutely glorious. Yeah, bend it like Southwell, they're saying. Oh, that is an absolute disaster for the Roosters. Kelleher and Koenig in each other's way. And now the Titans, straight after conceding, get a chance to hit back. So here's the debutant, Natapuna. It's a slow play of the ball. Ali Nati now to Destiny Brill. Scored the only try for Queensland in that origin last year. Such a dangerous play of the lock. Ali Nati goes to the short side, finds Kimiora Braley Nati, and now Ralph Strand Smith. Roosters asking if there was a little bobble in there. Short side they go for the crash play. And Tasman Gray is over for the Titans. The former Rooster scoring against her old side.
Well, that's a way to run onto the football. And the Roosters have only got themselves to blame after making the mistake and getting themselves back into the game from the kickoff. It was all set up there with the charging run. They got caught short again on that blind side. Have a look at that. They can't adjust quick enough. Very short there. Need another couple of people over there. That's just a charging, bullocking run. Gee, they've been good through the middle, haven't they, the Titans? That is a tremendous try. And well-deserved, too. They deserve this lead at half-time anyway. The Titans, they've played the better football. 14-6 with the kick to come.
And once again, it's a mistake from the Roosters which allowed the Gold Coast the opportunity to get themselves over the line, and they took advantage.
The other thing too, Nardi, the captain, the dummy half, beautiful skills, nice passing game, nice and crisp. You need that from your dummy half. You don't want the ball going in front of you or behind you. You want it right in the breadbasket when you're running at that sort of speed. Nice soft hands. I'm very impressed with her, the captain of the Titans.
Well, the goal kicking's been pretty good today. Canfield put one over from this kind of range on the other side. And swinging it back expertly. These two first-time kickers slotting them from everywhere. The Titans lead at 16-6 down to the sideline with Nico.
Yeah, Tasman Gray has certainly been busy throughout her NRLW career. Began her career at the Roosters in 2018. Won the comp with Brisbane the following year. Was at the Warriors last season. Now finds herself in Gold Coast colours. Queensland Origin representative, Jillaroos player. She's a superstar, Tasman Gray.
Yeah, thanks, Nico. That she is. And her side ahead by 10. In a good position as they chase their first ever win in the NRLW.
How good would that be? If you go on and win this game, the first ever win from the Titans. I'll never get that back. Never be done again. They're playing some confident footy.
Well, problems both sides have had with getting the kickoffs. Karina Brown with the mop-up work for the Titans. And she's driven back. That could have gone a whole lot more pear-shaped than it did. Politi up over the 10. Roosters really want to muscle up here. So Short and Burton, the replacement hooker out there for the Roosters, but haven't had much of the football lately. Don't want to get too much involved. There she is in the tackle and a penalty. It's going from bad to worse for the Roosters.
Not going to take the tap, is it? Not much confidence in kicking for touch. Lucky to get away with that one. They've got the football again.
Feel the energy of the Cbus Super Stadium. Doubleheader Titans and the Warriors in the NRL. The Titans and the Broncos in the NRLW. That's Saturday, March 19. You can secure your seats at nrl.com/tickets. The Titans will be loving that, getting back home to Cbus Super Stadium. Can they do it with a win under their belt? Well, they're going about it the right way at the moment. Flat and hard, and Tasman Gray looking for a double. She's going to go close. Burton and Sergis were there. Short side is the way they go, and Politi is just centimetres away, the Olympic gold medalist. Brill, Hale, and now onto the park is Jessica Elliston. Brought down in front of the sticks. Out of dummy half goes Destiny. Brill doesn't look confident. Has been held up by some strong Roosters defence.
Well, she's been moved into the dummy half area. And she's been busy, hasn't she? She's been their best player, Destiny Brill, in the first half. Unfortunately held up here by the look of it. Some desperation there. Everyone's trying to get over that stripe, aren't they?
Yeah, Short and Burton just doing enough.
At this point, the ball is still up, and Destiny Brill fails to get it to the ground. We have a decision.
Well, you could see that she didn't score there, but just how quickly she got back and got herself back into position there. Brill, to play the ball. She wants to get on with the game. No try. Let's get on with it.
So it will be a handover.
Nice tackle, was it?
I believe so. Oh, here she's pinched it back here, Destiny Brill. The one-on-one steal. Well, they'll get six more now, the Titans. Elliston. And caught there by Temera. Brill there at dummy half. Griffin, flat and hard to Canfield. That's a strong one-on-one tackle made by Joseph. Across the line now with Elliston. Not much doing on that particular play for the Titans, but they're in the middle of the ground here.
We need a quick play the ball here.
Bailey Nati, and here is Gray again getting up ahead of steam. She's desperate for a double, the former Rooster. Hale shovels it on to Natapuna. And that is the final play. So they've had some issues with their last tackle plays lately, the Titans. Maybe just not the message getting out there to the halves.
You've got to give a rap to the Roosters' defence there. They'd saved the try with a hold-up and a turnover, then got the ball stolen off from the first tackle. Here's the Titans bridging up too.
Well, they've had a lot of the ball in this first half. They're fresh and they are really muscling up in defence. Yasmin Meeks with a forceful run that for the Roosters. They needed that for a bit of momentum. Tafunga, the winger, getting involved. The try scorer for the Roosters in this first half. And now Keely Joseph. Spun around in the tackle. Almost broke free of Georgia Hale. Zahara Temera off the bench, the playmaker, looking to add some spark in the final minutes of this first half in Wollongong. Final play for McGregor. Politi comfortable underneath it. She gets it up over the 20. where she's met and put down by Kapani.
Just good play there by Politi. Just attacking the ball. The kick not brilliant there. Again from the Roosters. The kicking game's got to improve here in the second half. And their error rate too.
Yes, you've got to get all the way.
Titans have been a much better side so far. 16 points to 6 in front. And unlucky not to be further in front.
Nata Puna doing a lot of work on debut. Griffin turning it on the inside now for Power. And Shania Power is put to ground on the last play here for the Titans. Back it comes for Griffin. Doing a lot of the kicking for the Gold Coast today. That could have bounced anywhere. And Bridie Parker picked it up and saw space ahead of her. She palms off Griffin. She sees Politi. Has Kelly looming up on the inside. It's knocked down by Politi. That's a big play from Ivania Politi.
Now, we've seen a couple of clean breaks in this game of footy. Both sides have just got to support that ball carrier. You've just got to be on your game knowing that someone's going to make a long-range break. The chase through on this fullback in Parker hasn't been that good. She strides out, but where's the support? And there's a penalty for offside.
Timmer up. And McGregor onto Toga Tuki, playing out in the second row today. Has number 8 on the back, though. Joseph straightening up the attack for the Roosters.
If they can hang on to the ball here, the Roosters, they're good enough to score.
Here comes Kelleher, almost squeezing in between was the run of Yasmin Meeks. And now Temera. 5 metres away here, the Roosters. Final tackle. Big moment before halftime, and the pass was put down by McGregor. Not touched, according to the referee, by the Roosters halfback. But the Titans do enough. And it's a handover.
Gee, I like that tackle from Karina Brown there. On the right side wing there for the Titans. She had to come in and make a decision to make the tackle. It was a pearler. To shut anything down there from the Roosters. Put a body on the line, straight in to make that tackle. Made the decision and made it good.
Well, how significant could that be? Come the back end of this one. Right before halftime, the Titans with a huge defensive set there. Politi trying to get themselves out of their own red zone. Karina Brown, now Elliston. Less than 3 minutes remaining in this first half in Wollongong. Second round of season 4 of the NRLW. An upset potentially on the cards. Shania Powell looking for a hole to run through.
I know they've had a lot of ball, the Titans. 18 missed tackles for the Roosters in the first half. They've got to fix that up. They're going to get back into this game.
Griffin. Allowed to bounce, picked up by Peters. And it's just going to be a handover. So probably the final set of this first half for the Sydney Roosters. Can they make it a good one?
Very frustrating too. I know they've turned the ball over and made a number of errors, the Roosters, in the first half, but possession's been their biggest problem. They've got to get a lot more ball. They've shown what they can do when they get the footy, they can score. Made a number of breaks, but haven't had enough ball in this first half.
Burton. He's put the ball under the arm there, did Kapani. Getting late on in the tackle count here. Burton, Temera, across the line. Not much doing there for Keely Joseph. Very flat-footed. Final play potentially of the half here for the Roosters. And it's another poor pass out of dummy half. Picked up by Kelly. Could it create something, though? Surges. She's streaming through. Comes to the fullback. What a tackle
what
from
a
Politi.
Tackle.
That is massive in the final minute of the first half.
Well, that's a highlight of the first half for me. I know they lose 16-6.
Tied at Roosters.
Again, it's Paletti at the back there for the Gold Coast. Surges, what about her in broken field? Beautiful runner, great balance. And look at this for a front-on tackle. You won't see better than that. Gets a head in the wrong place, but that's courageous.
Clean now, Simone!
And once again, lack of support there for Surges, and no one there to pass it to. Tafunga was out to the right, but to Titan in between. And wow, put an asterisk next to that moment and review that come full time. Elliston in the dying embers of this first half. One which the Titans have dominated, but the Roosters so close to getting back into it. Knocked down, it looked to be, by Meeks, who is made the tackle on Yasmin Peters. And that is halftime in Wollongong. And it's been a fabulous first half. If you're a Gold Coast Titans fan, they were superb. The Roosters fought back. But at halftime, it's the Titans 16 leading the Roosters 6. Straight after the break, Hannah Hollis and the team will wrap up all that first half action.
Talofa, my name is Ruby Tui. I'm an outside back for the one and only Chiefs Manawa. We are so, so excited to be part of the first ever Sky Super Rugby Aupiki. It's just, it's spectacular, it's phenomenal, and most importantly, it's a huge honour. Like, this moment's not going to come around twice, so it's truly up to us what we do with it. You know, in this day and age, you never know what tomorrow's going to bring, so when I'm standing there on that field, my boots on and that jersey on, and the whistle goes, oh, it's going to be huge, huge, huge moment for women's rugby, for me, for my family, and for my team, the Wahinatua next to me, so this is huge.
Step inside the animal kingdom and get lost in the wonder of their natural world. From earth to the skies to the depths of the sea. Explore the lives of six incredible creatures in a special series of documentaries. The Natural World Collection starts Wednesday, March 9 on BBC Earth.
This is Tennis, the ATP Tour, live on Sky Sports. Impressive landscaping. And even better golf. At the Players.
The place to watch the Players' Championship.
Right here.
Right here.
Right here.
On Sky Sport.
Supercars are back! How good is that? What a day! Simply remarkable. Oh, yes! Can you believe what you are seeing?
Six Nations, live on Sky Sport.
Time to feel the power. Let's go! It's the power of the Pacific. DHL Super Rugby Pacific, live on Sky Sport.
Hi, I'm me, you're you, and this is the Sky Wi-Fi guy.
Isn't he cute?
He's here to help you see how your Wi-Fi is working in every nook and cranny of your home. He can see how it works here, and here, and even here. Oh, that's not good. This guy's great. And if he tells you your Wi-Fi sucks, maybe it's time to change up to Sky Broadband. It's made to entertain. Put your Wi-Fi to the test at skywifiguy.co.nz.
Kia whakaaturia.
Hit hard, cause scandal. Can't stop, I'm hard to handle. Don't care, my halo dips. My right to this is worth the risk. See now, I'm the wild one. I stole the balls of Randall. I know the patriarch don't fit the part. What I'm gonna start. Work, work, hada, hada. We work, work,
Show them.
Welcome back to NRLW on Fox, where the Gold Coast have raced out to a 10-0 lead before the Roosters were able to return serve. The Titans lead 16-6 at halftime with Sam Bremner and Joe Barrett with you as we take a look at the first half highlights. Joe, it looked like an eternity, but here Jasmine Peters does get the ball down to open scoring.
Yeah, no less than Hannah Southwell as the defender there. She did remarkably well to go over in that fashion, but it did seem to take forever for them to open the scoring and actually get the ball to the ground.
What I like about here, Joe, is how smart the Titans were in playing a little bit of football. Sometimes we get a bit bogged down in what we should do and what we've been told to do by our coaches. But I know in Jamie Feeney, he definitely would have told them structure, but also to look up and play what's in front of them. And that's exactly what they did with a smart kick off Grace Griffin.
And then the Roosters, they returned serve, Joe.
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, Titans got such a strong start on them last week. They couldn't score in the first half, but the Roosters are starting to show what we know they're capable of. And that try there looked too easy.
What do you think they'd be taking into the second half? Sam, they're down by 10.
Oh, I think definitely their error rate needs to get down. It was 7 errors in the first half to 3 from the Titans. I think if they can hold onto the ball and complete their sets, a couple of the times they didn't even get to their kick. I don't know if that's a lack of communication. They didn't know it was their last, but they need to get a good kick and some good field position.
In the absence of Corbin McGregor for the Roosters, we know she's still out because of COVID. Brady Parker there at fullback, but Isabel Kelly seems to be dropping to the back, Sam, occasionally.
Yes, she does. It's more so when they're getting over halfway. Izzy seems to be getting her hands on the ball a little bit more and filling in for that fullback position. And she is a bit of a threat there. You can see the defence holds up on her a lot more when she's sweeping out the back. And she's just a player that she wants to be more involved. And the coach has said it since last week that he wants Isabel and Jess to be more involved. So I think it's a smart move getting her to play that fullback position, especially in the attacking half. She set up 2 great tries. One near try with Jess Surges, 1 try. But she's definitely a threat. The defence doesn't know what they're going to do. I think it was disappointing that Jess, was a bit of a missed opportunity there. I really would have backed Jess there to take on Ivani Politi for pace. But she went with a little bit of footwork. But I think if Jess can get her hands on the ball more, it'll be sensational for the Roosters to have another crack in the second half.
It was a strong way for the Roosters to finish the second half. We've got more to come from this match, but our final game of the day is between the Dragons and the Eels. Let's head to Wynn Stadium now and catch up from one of the Parramatta stars, who's standing by with Darcy McDonald.
Tiana Penatani, what was the bus trip home like after that thrilling 1-point win over the Knights last week?
The bus trip home was pretty fun. You know, the girls were really excited to get such an exciting win with Maddie Studden, you know, obviously kicking that field goal in the last minute. So it was a really good morale booster to get that first win in round one, being such a fresh team and none of us actually playing together in the NRLW before. I think it really boosted the confidence of especially those younger players who were on debut and, got their first taste of the big stage.
The Dragons have a Ferrari named Emma Tonegado in their team this week. How much homework have you done on her today?
She's one of my old teammates back in the other code. But, yeah, she's an incredible athlete, Emma. Obviously, she's not the only player in the team. So we obviously placed a lot of focus on her as a threat, but didn't, rule out the rest of the star players that they have in their squad as well. They've got some great players in their forward pack as well as, Rachel Pearson at half as well. So there's quite a few threats in that lineup, but yeah, no doubt Emma Tonegado is a big threat for them, and we won't take them lightly.
Tiana, thanks for your time and best of luck today.
Thank you.
Well, the Dual International is in action for our third game of the day, but up next, second half between the Roosters and the Titans as netball returns home to Fox Sports in 2022, and the action gets underway on March 26.
Footy, league, step aside. There's a new girl in town, and she means business. Fox, the new home of netball.
Sky Sport has the ICC Women's Cricket World Cup.
It's time to shine, best believe. Yes, time to shine, yes indeed. For my girls, now let's roll. We're turning up, yeah, it's time to go. With the party at, gonna bring some soul. We're gonna put the good stuff, the good stuff.
My goodness, man.
Absolutely brilliant.
Live in Aotearoa. Let's go. White Ferns Bangladesh, Monday, live on Sky Sport 3. Coverage proudly brought to you by ANZ.
Once a warrior, always a warrior. Join me and club legends for the untold stories. No cliches, just strong opinions and insiders' insight.
Only the warriors can produce this.
Catch us Wednesday nights on Sky Sport 1 and also on demand.
Here we go, ANZ Premiership Netball, live Sky Sport.
There's two kinds of people, Dad. The ones who have a B-bot and the ones who don't.
Hey, guys.
Oh, sorry, I'm in your shot.
Oh, I have a filter for that.
Really, you need a B-bot to have a social life?
Yeah, Dad, kind of.
I don't want you addicted to some device. Yeah, though.
I got what you want. Dad, you got me one!
Hi, Barney. I'm your best friend out of my box.
What are you doing?
Barney, your B-bot is like super weird.
I am Barney's B-bot. Will you come to my secret shed and like him?
No. Okay, Ron, a bunch of your code is missing.
Boom!
You're supposed to know everything about me.
Hair, brown, height, 4'11".
5'11 would be better. Girls would not laugh at you.
Hey!
Making friends is what he's for.
Friend request? Friend request.
If he can't do that, he's like literally pointless.
Oh, Rose is pulling my head off!
You can't pull his head off!
We'll get in trouble!
Okay, I cannot pull his head off. I have no mega safety controls and stuff.
Copy him. Find that code.
Unlock.
Woo!
I'd better look into that.
You think?
I'm not leaving you behind.
They will send you to the Crusher.
We'll go to the Crusher together.
No! Crushing is not fun.
Not fun? Where is it?
Find the rogue.
We don't need anyone else. I currently have one friend.
That is sad and also tragic.
Run for it!
No problem. Are we having fun with me? Hey, buddy, how's the B-bot?
Both of you, hands where I can see them.
Maybe turn it off and on again.
The Breakers are back all season on Sky Sport.
We're going to eat a baby.
Yes.
Okay.
Bake-off isn't normal, is it?
Bit childish, but, you know.
Got a handshake.
Do you look a lot like Where's Wally?
Come on, Brad.
Girls who are pickers wear big knickers.
Don't ask me, I have no idea.
What do you think it looks like?
All naked.
This is a family show, right? Is that 4.5 hours worth of work?
Well, it was for me.
Thursday, the Great British Bake Off. Prime.
Panthers, Sea Eagles. Thursday, live Sky Sport 4.
The Titans are chasing history this afternoon in Wollongong. They lead 16-6, searching for their first win in NRLW history. But up against them, the two-time grand finalists, the Sydney Roosters. Can they fight back in this second half? That is the question blocker.
Well, the big thing for the Roosters, as we mentioned, they've been in that last couple of grand finals and just doesn't happen for you. It looks to me like they've just come out here in that first half and thought, oh, we'll just go through the motions. I mentioned it a little bit earlier. 7-3 errors. Too many errors there from the Roosters and their completion rate was pretty poor. They've had the coach get at them at halftime. Let's hope he can do something for them. Both sides look very tired with about 10 minutes to go before halftime. So let's hope they're freshened up. But a great performance from the Gold Coast Titans in the first half. Let's hope they can go on with it.
So the Roosters with a mountain to climb get it started in the second 35 minutes. And it's Elliston off the kickoff bringing it back for the Gold Coast Titans. One of eight Origin reps in this Gold Coast Titans side. They've got six internationals. Compare that to the Roosters. Six Origin reps and four internationals. So look at how that shakes out and you think maybe not surprising to see the scoreline the way it is, even though the Roosters were favoured in this one. Four players it takes to bring down Tasman Gray. Brill is there at dummy half, feeding Georgia Hale.
I tell you where they are winning the battle, through the middle. They're keeping it pretty simple. Some power running there from the Titans. They got over the top of the Roosters in the first half in that area.
Oh, what a cutout pass, but spilled by Lauren Dam. That would have been a fabulous passage of play had it gone to hand. How about that from Politi?
She's well skilled, isn't she, Politi? Just sums it up quickly, comes into the second man. The pass over the top, maybe a little bit too difficult to take, but that was nearly a free run to the goal line. Maybe you looked up and saw a little bit of white line fever there. Dan puts it down.
Nico Paharillo is sideline for us. How are things down on the sideline at the start of this second half, Nico?
Yeah, guys, Roosters coach John Strange at halftime said he wants his team again to improve a little bit here.
Yeah, we'll come back to you in a second, Nico. Brill has come up with the ball again. And now on debut, Natapuna. Back out there at the beginning of this second half. Brill fires that pass to Griffin. The Roosters defense was up quickly. Kelleher was there. And now Keely Joseph and Burton bring down Elliston. Brill's pass is a bit of a shocker. Picked up by Gray, though. Almost burst through the Roosters' front line defense. Politi, Bailey Nati, and then Brill shoveled it onto Natapuna, who has put it down. And the Roosters come up with it.
A little bit of side-to-side stuff there from the Titans to start this second half. Make their most yardage through the middle there. And they can win that play the ball, quick play the ball. Instead of passing the ball side-to-side just for the sake of it, you won't get anywhere. The Roosters hang on early in this second half.
Nico, what was the message from the coaches at halftime?
Apologies. Yeah, the message from the coach, John Strange, was actually that he wants his side to improve on the completion rate, control the ruck better. Conversely, Titans coach Jamie Feeney was happier with the completions from his side and was pleased with how well they played down their right-hand side and challenged his team to do the same down the left.
Yeah, thanks, Nico. Jamie Feeney, the former Roosters head coach, took them to the grand final in 2020, now at the helm at the Titans. Wouldn't he love a win against his former side?
Well, it was Koenig that tried to offload the ball. Now, that's what happens when you start to play catch-up football, trying to start to force it. Koenig comes away with the error for the Roosters. Look at this, down the middle. I'll tell you what, I'll be sending the message out to, come on, boys, or ladies, let's attack their middle.
Brill. Rayleigh Nati, now Politi chiming in, cut out pass, and she's put it down again. Lauren Dam with the line wide open.
Well, she did all the hard work there. She caught the football, looked up and saw. I'm going to get across the stripe here. Look at her hogging the sideline. Great play, another brilliant pass. Does all the hard work, catches it, and then drops it.
It is getting a little slippery. You can see the camera has a little bit of water on the lens, but Laura Dam will be so frustrated.
She might have been thinking about the try celebration after she put the agate down.
Isabel Kelly bringing it out for the Roosters. They have dodged a huge bullet, a couple in this start of this second half. That's the issue for the Roosters, the completion rate. Down at 56%. Last week against the Broncos, it was 55. You cannot afford to be down there.
Well, you can't win, especially when the Titans are playing this style of footy. Had the ball stuck early in the second half here, they could have scored another couple of tries already.
Kelleher into the Titans half. It is the final play, though. McGregor giving Brown a little bit to think about, and Karina Brown happy to little trickle over the line in the end.
And, play the
she
ball.
Did well there, Brown, not playing at the ball. That was a little bit better from the Karina, Roosters there. Got it to their kick. They haven't been able to do that on a lot of occasions in this game. You just get a fair bit of fatigue too when you're not completing, you're turning the ball over.
Yeah, just wait, girl. Georgia, half a step back.
See if they can bridge up now defensively, the Roosters. They're having trouble with this Titans pack. He's just charging over the advantage line. He's another good run.
Don't forget the MotoGP is back later tonight. You can tune in to watch Aussies Jack Miller and Remy Gardner battle it out at the season opening event in Qatar. Live and exclusive on Fox Sports from 8:55 p.m. tonight.
Held there, Kaylee, you're four.
The Titans, I'll be hoping to be celebrating at that point their first win in the NRLW. And that's a strong tackle on Steph Hancock. That's a forward pass. But the held call was made by Cara Lee Nolan, and that's why the Titans get away with it. So now they're going to play the ball on halfway the Gold Coast. Still no change to that halftime scoreline. Georgia Hale, dummy half there in 14, former young New Zealander of the year. And now slicing through is Power. Final play for the Titans. Dummy initially, the double pump, and it all goes awry for the Titans. Grace Griffin caught on the last, and she's absolutely filthy that she wasn't given the pass earlier.
Well, they were so slick in the first half out of dummy half, weren't they? The Titans, it's a little bit of sloppy play there to start the second half. That ball's got to hit the target straight away. Give your kickers time. Roosters have certainly got the style of player that can get them back in the game. Just got to hang on to the ball.
Temera, couple of steps off the right, and then again looking for that space.
Give space. Go three.
Was fired on by Burton to Predibon, who's back out there, the starting front rower.
Well, they need her out there. She straightens them up. Lost their way when she went off in the first half.
Isabel Kelly wrapped up there by Jasmine Peters, who scored the opener for the Titans, now preventing tries in defence. Kelleher to McGregor, looks to measure that grubber kick. It's going to take a great kick to beat Politi and get into the in goal. She's fantastic at fullback, the gold medalist from the 2016 Olympics with the Aussie women's sevens rugby team. She's had a day today, blocker, the Titans fullback.
She's a superstar. Looks like that she's a couple of steps ahead of everyone else. A couple of those passes there, the cutout passes, and that's the way that she's been able to charge the footy back. The teammates will get used to her too. As the season goes on, she's a superstar.
Well, how about the battle for the Gillaroos number one jersey? When you think about that, Politi, Tamika Upton from the Broncos. Fabulous. Tonicato from the Dragons as well. You just keep adding to that list. And Tafunga puts it down for the Roosters. They can ill afford mistakes like that. I know it's getting a little slippery. You can see the rain falling, blocker. But they're just building up again for the Roosters.
They're playing the right tactics, aren't they? The Titans. Where are we having it, Karina? Putting up that midfield bomb there. And as you said, these sort of conditions, the rain's starting to come down pretty heavy. Loss of the ball again from the Roosters, inviting the Gold Coast side to attack straight away. I reckon Paletti got himself involved in the game. Just on the left-hand side here. Geez, there's been some wonderful cut-out passes. I mentioned that a couple of minutes ago, but she was a class act.
Grace Griffin turning it back on the inside.
Move, Georgia.
Burton here we are. Making the tackle for the Roosters. And Georgia Hale spun away from the first tackle, held now by Koenig. Olivia Koenig pulling down the run there from Hale. Thrill to Steph Hancock, just days away from celebrating her 40th birthday. Wouldn't she love an early celebration with a try here? Rayleigh Nati with the run around. Politi gets the pass on. And Ralph Strand-Smith just held by Jess Surges, pulled away from the line.
Tell you what, they're lucky they've got Jess Surges there. She's made some telling one-on-one tackles.
Gray out of dummy half, pops it up this time. No!
She's lost it.
Lauren Dam with
a
third
Jess offside
opportunity. It could be an offside though.
Coming back to a penalty if it's a no-try. We've got a no-try knock on Titans here. Can you just confirm she loses it over the goal line?
The words there of Cara Lee Nolan, so The bunker will have a look, but it looks as though she spilled it, blocker here.
Damn, again it is with the opportunity. No, she's lost it on the way down.
You've got to feel sorry for Lauren Dam.
Laura Dam drops the ball over the try line and fails to ground it. The on-field decision of a penalty for offside previous will stand. We have a decision.
Girls! Girls, it's a penalty against Jess. She failed to make the line.
Penalty against this Jess one. Surges.
The penalty.
I think they'll go for a two, won't they? The Titans, come on, keep the heat on.
The penalty, she's offside. Destiny, just want to help with the mark, Jake, so I can get out.
Lauren Dam, she'll be desperate for one. She's had a handful that she could have scored, has none at the moment.
Okay.
Steph Hancock off the right. Hannah Southwell went underneath, didn't lay a glove on Steph Hancock. Only five away, backing away towards the line. The veteran prop, Bailey Nati, Griffin, Politi hasn't scored for the Titans, scored three for the Warriors back in the 2020 season. Elliston, catchy get there under the post. Pulled back is Jessica Elliston. Brittany Brayley Nati onto Kimiora Brayley Nati. Around the back is Griffin. Rafstrand Smith. Looking for a hole is Tasman Gray. Already got over today, the former Rooster. Brayley Nati puts it on the toe. And it was knocked on by the Roosters. Another set of defence. And is it going to be a captain's challenge? It will be. And
the on-field decision is knock-on Roosters.
You can understand.
Roosters are disputing the decision of a knock-on.
Even if this is a bit of a pie-in-the-sky decision from the Roosters, you can understand they just want a breather. So we'll have a look and see whether it was a clear knock-on or whether it was off the boot.
Just looking to determine if the Roosters player knocks on. Yeah, it's the left on. Hand of the Roosters the player, and she propels it towards her opposition's goal line. The challenge is unsuccessful.
Yep. Definitely a knock on there from Jordan Burton, but what it does give the Roosters is just a chance to have a breath. Step up and defend again. They've had to make 187 tackles, the Roosters, to the Titans 103. With that kind of difference for the Roosters last week against the Broncos, you can't win matches and you're making a lot of errors. Yeah, it's quite substantial, the difference in tackles made by these two.
Great place to attack from, right in the middle of the field. See if they can come up with a scrum play here, the Titans.
Okay, break and short.
Brayley Nati, half back off the scrum. Tasman Gray.
Okay.
Pulled to ground by Keely Johnson. Keely Joseph, it was. And now Elliston, met by Predabon.
Okay, Sarah, move.
Good play, the ball.
And then Brayley Nati saw the opportunity and dives over underneath the posts. Her first try in the NRLW in more than 3 years.
Just have a look. A couple of players left on the ground. It was a great play, the ball there. It was Georgia Hale, the quick play, the ball. Got to her feet quickly. As I mentioned, the first half, Nati just picks up opportunities, knows when to run. Made a long-range break in the first half. Just off the back of that quick play, the ball. Finally, with all the ball in the second half, the Titans have scored.
So the captain extends the lead for the Titans and takes them another step closer to a history-making afternoon.
That is a great nose of knowing when to run. And you see a couple of players left in and around the play, the ball. On the ground, a couple of dead marines, we call them, just laying in and around the play, the ball, straight away, takes off Nati. and they couldn't hang on any longer, the Roosters.
So Kimiora, Brayley Nati slots her first goal in the NRLW. Pretty simple one. Zara Canfield obviously off the ground, not taking that one.
Yep.
And let's go down to the sideline with Nico.
Yeah, Captain Courageous Brittany Brownlee Nati brings with her plenty of experience. She was the inaugural female Dally M medalist in 2018, has represented Queensland and Australia, won the QRLW Premiership with Burley Bears last year as well, so continuing to inspire is Brittany Brownlee Nati.
You keep mentioning Steph Hancock being 40 years of age. I suppose the big thing is she's waited so long for the Women's League to take off. 40. Can you imagine playing at 40? I'd like her to play at 30.
That's impressive. It is very impressive. Straight after this, the Dragons are in action. They are taking on the Parramatta Eels. Round two of the NRLW continuing right here on Fox League. Do not miss it. The NRL, it's back this week. It's a blockbuster opening game with Premiers Penrith facing a turbocharged Manly. That's at Bluebet Stadium. Coverage begins 7 p.m. on Fox League. That's on Thursday. Do not miss a minute. An error made here by the Titans. Roosters, if they are to get back into this one, they have to make something happen soon. Predabon. And Burton beating Southwell was met in a solid tackle by the captain, the try scorer. Took a break from the 2020 season due to work commitments, did Brittany Brayley Nati. Now Kelleher out to the left for Yasmin Meeks. Making the switch out to the wing for this one. And a penalty, fair enough. Hands all over from Yasmin Peters.
Wait. Okay, when you're ready.
Burton to Togatuki.
Okay, just move.
They really need to score this set, the Roosters. Finally some ball down the attacking end. And it's Keely Joseph who's going to play it centimetres away. The line just there. Burton with the crash play for Togatuki, who powers away over. What a way to score your first in the NRLW and get the Roosters back within striking distance.
Don't you love it, the ruck play. It's a set play here, the crossover, and then the turn back on the inside. Togatuki gets over the stripe. It's the second time with some big charges in this set that she's been involved. You're not going to stop her there. That's a powerful try. After a mistake from the Titans after they scored, not being able to get to their kick. Great to see some ruck plays back into the game, and that is a good set play. The Roosters, for the first time in the second half, score.
And even Ivania Politi could not stop Sarah Togatuki. The New South Wales Origin player. Back with the Sydney Roosters. She did spend some time with the Dragons in 2019. The Roosters either side, and now back in season four of the NRLW with the tricolours. So Hannah Southwell, much simpler conversion here. And she has two from two this afternoon. The Roosters are back within 10 blocker.
Yeah, that's a great try. Well set up. Good planning. They would have practiced that over the whole off-season. Togatuki, too strong, too big. Titans didn't come off their line to meet her there, but that's a powerful run. Just hope they throw chances now. I hope they throw the ball around a bit, the Roosters. They've shown that they can make clean breaks. They made more than the Titans in the first half. So the ball can hang on. If they can hang on to the football and chance their hand a little bit, it'll give them confidence that try.
Well, can they get back here? The Sydney Roosters. They'll have first use of the football. But the Titans getting us back started here. Don't forget, though, coming up on Monday at 7:30, Lara Pitt, Greg Alexander and Michael Ennis ahead of the biggest season ever on Fox League. The season preview. Get up to date with everything you need to know about your club on the 2022 NRL season preview. 7:30 on Monday. Do not miss that one. Must watch television on Fox League. Like this is the NRLW here. And the Roosters are trying to fight back through Isabel Kelly. She got the ball back on the inside. Was it played at? That will be the decision to make for the touchy and Cara Lee Nolan.
She couldn't do much there. Isabel Kelly got on the outside of the opposition there, tried to force the ball back in, but you'll find it'll be the Titans' ball here. That's accidentally come off one of the Titans.
Yeah, certainly not played out there by Peters or Brown. And once again, a promising attacking play for the Roosters comes undone.
Well, see, you look up at the scoreboard, you're behind 22 points to 12. Okay. 16 to go. You're starting to think we're going to try something here. She's going to be forced into touch anyway. Titans get the football back.
Long pass into the arms of Politi. Mentioned that gold medal from the 2016 Olympics. Also scored in that gold medal match against New Zealand. And she's won her side a penalty.
That's a big play. Winning a penalty like that after the Roosters have crawled their way somewhat back in. Kick for touch straight away on the attack. She's been their best player here this evening.
It wasn't a great touch finder. And Bridie Parker comes up with it, the Roosters fullback. So a touch of good fortune for the tricolours. And now, maybe this is their route back into the game. 10 points behind, just over 15 to play.
Gee, you got to find touch with those sort of kicks, haven't you? You get yourself the opportunity. There's a penalty. That's a fair one too. Saw Tasman Gray with a hand on the football, just trying to rip at it. Roosters, they go for touch. No, they take the quick tap.
It's Predibon. You've been so impressed with Taylor Predibon blocker. Charging it straight up into the line. Higgins to the try scorer from just a few moments ago.
Just need their halves to take control now, the Roosters. McGregor and Kelleher. They need to get their hands on the football as much as they can.
Keely Joseph. With McGregor.
Okay, move, not on her.
Racine McGregor. It's a bit of a slow play, the ball. Now Hannah Southwell. The lock says, let's get moving here. Final play for the Roosters. The rain is falling. Where do they go here? Along the turf. Will be a little challenging for Politi. Calm as you like. With the ball dribbling towards her and the rain falling.
Yeah, too easy there for Politi to clean up. You've got to try and kick away from her, make it run for the footy and give her a bit of energy. But that ball bounced to her in the second bounce. The game's starting to get a little bit sloppy now. Will they go for touch here or take the quick tap? Politi coming up. Says, I'll take it, I'll find touch. Yeah, off the side of the boot, but anyway, it goes into touch. That side's looking very tired, aren't they? Maybe they've added an extra 5 minutes each half onto the league now. Let's hope that they don't get too fatigued. It's going to take them a while to get used to playing those extra 10 minutes a game.
Taylor Holt.
Yeah, so this season, 70-minute matches after hour clashes for the first three seasons of the NRLW. So we're almost into that final 10 minutes. Brace Griffin, 5'8 for the Titans, actually recruited by Ali Brigginshaw to the Valley's Diehards in the QRL Premiership. That shows you the kind of quality she has, the Titans 5'8. Can she close out this match? Now it looks as though she'll be asked to take this one back, Destiny Brill.
Yeah, mate, I've got it. Okay, it'll be tackle four.
She's been good too, Brill. She's a handful, isn't she? Always. Gets out the other side of the tackles, finds the front, quick play the balls.
18 years of age as well.
You it is there. Look at that. Quick getting up. That should have been a penalty, you know. That's a second grab.
Yeah, certainly had appeals for that. Now, Sarah Togatuki, is this an injury or is it cramp? He's done a lot of work. 20 tackles. Scored that try. Switch to the second row today as well. Just crunched in there, that tackle. Maybe a bit of whiplash, potentially.
A bit of head clash, was it?
Not feeling the left calf, it was. And she's right up there, and it's unsurprising that the Roosters have the top three in the tackle count. Maddie Studden, the hero last week for the Parramatta Eels, kicking the first field goal in the NRLW to get them the 2 points. Their first ever win against the Knights. They're in action straight after this against the Dragons, who also won in round one against the Titans. These two sides winless to start the campaign. One is going to get the job done, you would expect. Unless we get a draw, nothing would surprise us. Grace Griffin for the arms of Tafunga.
Okay, Georgia, move.
Bridie Parker has run over 100 metres today. That time, she lost a few. She's been outstanding, the Roosters fullback. Both have been. Politi as well for the Titans. The fend there from Kelly on Kraley Nati. Just short of halfway, the Roosters.
Going to get some early ball to surges here. We saw just on the stroke of half time, and she just carved straight through the middle, but hasn't had that many opportunities in this game so far.
Southwell puts it under the arm. Final play here for the Sydney Roosters. McGregor. Pressure from Brayley Nati. Bounces awkwardly for Dam. Scooped up by Politi. She beats a couple. Ivania Politi. That should get her over the 100 metres for today. The Gold Coast Titans in possession here. Less than 12 minutes away from their first ever win in the NRLW. Karina Brown out of dummy half. What a history-making day it would be for the Queensland side. It's been a tough week for everyone in southeast Queensland. Great news today that the Titans are going to put $100,000 to flood relief for southeast Queensland and also northern New South Wales. And they're doing everyone proud back at home right here, right now. Final tackle. It comes to Hale. They're going to go through the hands. Tasman Gray on the toe. Lauren Dam after it. She wants to make up for those mistakes before, but it just crosses the line. Bridie Parker seeing it over.
Well, that was good footy, wasn't it? It's been a bit of a bugbear here in the whole game for the Titans with their kicking game. She did well at the back too, Parker. Not to play at that ball. This is a tough position to be in. Some tough runs needed to be made now. 10 metres out from their own line. They've got to try and start to find some passes, the Roosters. Chance their hand a bit more. Can't just go straight through the motions. One out running. You can't do it when you're behind on the scoreboard.
Almost inside the final 10 minutes. Another mistake from the Sydney Roosters. Make it 13 for the afternoon. 17 last week.
Well, the Titans can put them to the sword right now in this set. There's a mistake from the Roosters again. Here comes the Titans. Who's it going to be?
Can they try and seal this victory? Their first competition points in the NRLW. The Roosters cannot concede here. Into the arms of Shannon Martor. She knows how to get across the line. Scored last week. Brayley Nati to Hale. Rastran Smith juggled it. Got it back to Politi. She was tackled around the head by Surges. And a penalty for the Titans.
She's had to make some telling tackles, Surges, that time. Got caught wrong-footed. Had to make that tackle. been put under pressure plenty of times on her right side. The Titans gifted the ball again. Surely they've got to put them down here. Surely they've got to score.
Steph Hancock. 5 metres away. The veteran front rower, Hale, and now Griffin, smothered by Kelly. Can they create something here, the Gold Coast? Power. Brought down by Parker and Southwell. Second effort there, so she'll be asked to play it. They haven't really thrown anything at the Roosters yet. Just through the hands. It's simple defensive work from the Roosters at this point. Late on in the tackle count for the Gold Coast. Short side they go. It bounces up almost into the arms of Jasmine Peters. And Yasmin Meeks has somehow got it back into the field of play. It's all null and void, though, because it is going to be Roosters ball anyway.
Kept charging up that short side, didn't they? Just tried to rush things a little bit. You find that was a double knock on. They got themselves back in the field of play that time, but the Roosters will get the football back.
Just ricocheting off Togatuki up into Peters, and the knock on you can see there clearly.
It was off Peters.
So Kelleher will be taken just short of the 20-metre line. Nico Paharillo is down sideline. How's the intensity down there, Nico?
Oh, it's absolutely fantastic. Ben, as you mentioned, it would be an historic victory for the Titans. Just a conditions update, gentlemen. Blocky, you mentioned some of the errors. The rain is coming down, but it's not just that. The wind may also be playing a factor. There's a pretty strong northerly breeze, and it may explain some of the reluctance to kick for touch in this game.
Thanks, Nico. Koenig jammed in there by Rafstrand Smith and also Lauren Dam. McGregor just shoveling that pass on.
Last tackle.
And the Roosters with the ball in the arms of Keely Joseph. They're going to have to kick from inside their own half. Racine McGregor gets some height on it, taken by Lauren Dam. Running across field, now straightens. And put down 15 short of halfway. Karina Brown. She's strong run there.
She's come in and done a lot of work, hasn't she, Brown? And they've needed someone to take that ball forward.
Oh, Martor has been crunched in there.
She's twisted her knee on the way down here. Just buckled over the top.
Came spilling free.
There it is.
Oh, just jammed in there, the leg, the tackle from Southwell up over the top. Another strong effort from the Gold Coast Titans front rower, former Queensland Red and Wallaroo. Also played for the Queensland Origin team. That's a lot of weight on the ankle and lower leg. Shannon Martor.
Okay, Moyer.
You ain't seen that in any game, don't you? Just the way that the tackle's over the top and the leg gets caught underneath.
And she does look in some distress. So final 6 minutes on the way. There's Southwell Parker and Hilboana underneath. That body weight on the legs. So final 6 minutes here, Blocker. What are the Roosters talking about at this point as we see Shannon Martor? This is a sad sight. Chaired from the ground. And hopefully it's not as bad as what we fear as the Dragons go through their warm-ups on the field over from Wynn Stadium. They're taking on the Parramatta Eels. Both sides looking for a 2-from-2 start to the campaign. That's a big start when you're looking towards finals.
Ask me the question about the Roosters. I mentioned it 5 minutes ago. They've got to try and chance their hand if they are to win. I'd rather go down if I'm going to go down. I'd go down swinging. That one out running and trying to charge through the middle hasn't worked all game for them. So you need to get to the ball. You need to get the ball to Surges and Kelly. Those sort of... Oh, no. Can you believe that?
Big knock on and another knock on, so there'll be no advantage. Just confirmation there that Hill Moana on report for that tackle. Just that weight on the legs, attacking the legs, the decision from
really?
Cara Lee Nolan.
Gee, I reckon that's an accident. That one.
I do too. I thought it was an accident, yeah. Yeah, certainly. So let's hope Shannon Martor is okay, but doesn't. Her. The Titans now, big set of defence here because there's just over 5 minutes remaining. They don't want to let in a try here because otherwise it's going to make things really interesting as they chase their first ever win in the NRLW. Southwell grinding it up the middle for the Roosters. They're halfway through this set. Higgins. Back to McGregor. Now Surges gets the pass to Tafunga. He's already scored today. Lian Tafunga. Inside the 10. And they show some magic in attack here, the Roosters. Nothing at the moment to test the Gold Coast Titans. Final play. Higgins. Koenig. Get there! Tries in back-to-back matches for Olivia Koenig. And the Roosters, they are right back into this one. Pending, of course, the bunker giving it the all clear. She's saying she scored it. It looked to be a little bounce, but...
Yeah, she looks like a handful here. I don't think this one will tell us. Got on the outside shoulder there. Too big and too strong. Stretches over. The back end shot will tell us whether she's got the football down. The show and the go, gets on the outside. That's a try. A point of the ball down. Looked like it spewed out, but that's a try.
As we touched on last week, Blocker, a fascinating story. Olivia Koenig has represented the Indigenous All-Stars last year and then the Māori All-Stars this year. She has both Māori heritage and her dad is an Indigenous Australian, so has represented both teams in the All-Stars clashes and is starring for the Roosters this year. Two tries in her first two matches in the NRLW.
She could have got one in the first half too. Remember that line that she ran in the first half and the ball was just passed a little bit too hard to her. And those guys are running on the ball like that. You need soft hands. Try and throw it through them. That was a little bit of individual brilliance there from Koenig. She backed herself. Good to see.
So Southwell planted over a harder conversion than this in the first half. This is to bring it back within 4 points. A converted try would win it for the Roosters if Hannah Southwell can convert here and slices it. So it's going to take a converted try for the Sydney Roosters to get back level and send us into golden point extra time. Maybe that game will be pushed back a bit, the Dragons and the Eels. Straight up after this one on Fox League, a triple header in the NRLW.
But you have a look at all the stats, it's been the Titans comfortably, but we're going to go right down to the wire here by the look of it. They've got some strike players in their side, the Roosters. Let's hope fatigue hasn't set in too much. Have a dig. Let's go.
Well, how good is this? The Eels won it with the last play of the game last week against Newcastle. Could we have that kind of finish here? Looked to be someone offside from the kickoff. It was Georgia Hale. They'll get away with it, though, will they? Yes. Play on here for the Roosters. Hannah Southwell with the ball in hand. That's a good take from Bridie Parker. She's been probably their best today.
Hold on his left. Hold!
Koenig. So they're probably going to get two sets of six, the Roosters. With 2.5 minutes remaining. Burton is backslammed. Elliston across there, and that has hurt the utility player, Shorten Burton. Was it over the horizontal blocker?
You're asking the wrong bloke here. Like, that is a classic good tackle. Gonna knock the wind straight out of you. But who knows these days?
Well, you know what? I think...
Okay.
I reckon it'll be a penalty to the Roosters.
I think it should be okay as well. I don't think it went over the horizontal. It was just a hard tackle, wasn't it? We will wait and we will see. Because it's a huge play in the game if it's a penalty.
Benny boy, I'll tell you what, mate. It's not a great feeling when you get picked up like that. And all you can see is, if it's a night game, stars. If it's a day game... Well, today, anyway, the cloudy sky, it's not comfortable.
Here we go. Certainly the backside that hits the ground first. No penalty.
Well done.
And the ball has come free here. And, of course, the Roosters, well, they couldn't challenge if they thought it was an illegal strip. Must have all dropped off the Titans and... Braylee Nazi emerged with the ball. Shania Power. He's going to play it inside the Roosters' half. Probably the same equation still for the Roosters in that they'll get one more set, but they've got to defend here. Problem is, they'll probably start it well inside their own 20. Roosters defending strongly here. They have to. Shania Power is feeling the right arm. Now Georgia Hale. Politi chiming in off the hands of Tafunga. Lauren Dam took it this time.
Six again, will it be?
It should be. Yes, it is. First tackle here. Roosters player on the turf. It may well be Bridie Parker. No, she is behind the play of the ball, the fullback. So that's at least better news for the Roosters. It's Racine McGregor. And they're down to 12. Elliston. Could they seal it here, the Gold Coast? The Roosters need a miracle from here. The Titans looking for their first win in the NRLW. Hale gets it onto Hancock. She gets it up to Braylee Nati, spots the gap. Braylee Nati spinning and getting over for her second. And the Titans are going to win for the first time in the NRLW, a history-making afternoon on the Gold Coast.
Well, I'd love to be on the bus trip back to the airport and then on the airplane. How good's this going to be again? She just adds that little bit something different, Stephanie Hancock. There's a fourth offload in this game of footy. Nardi is straight on the spot too. Here it is. Just struggles for every centimetre here. Look, spins out, offloads the footy. There's three in the tackle. That's brilliant play. Throws the dummy. Good strength shown. And they deserve the win too. They've been far and away the better side in this game of footy. The Titans... their first ever win. How good?
As long as you're alive, me, you can move on.
And as we said, it's such a difficult time for everyone back home on the Gold Coast. What an afternoon for you all, witnessing the Titans claiming their first competition points in the NRLW. I hope this has lifted the spirits. So the kick is waved away from Shania Power. It doesn't matter though, it's all smiles for the Gold Coast. A golden afternoon for the Gold Coast Titans, a piece of history, a first win in the NRLW. The Titans win it 26-16, and the two-time grand finalists, the Roosters, are none from two. Questions to be asked at the start of the campaign.
Well, it's a jubilant day for the Titans and a historic one for the club. The Gold Coast enjoying their first win in the NRLW, announcing themselves to this competition, running in 5-3 over the Roosters, the score at full time. 16-26, a 10-point win. Sam Bremner, Joe Barrett with you in the studio as we take a look at the full-time highlights, all thanks to Telstra. Sam, an honesty session this week, thanks to the Titans coach, Jamie Feeney, and this was a Gold Coast outfit. Sharp turnaround from last week.
Oh, a very sharp turnaround. I think they would have done a lot of work on the errors that they had last week, but they came out firing. There was so much intensity in today's game. But like I said earlier, I think they just used their smarts a bit more. They looked up, played a lot of football, and as did the Roosters, but I feel like the Roosters just left it a little bit late to come back into the game. A couple of missed opportunities, and the Titans tend to capitalise on those opportunities a little bit more, and that's why they've come away with the win.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with Sam there, and you can see the way the Titans combined, running from dummy half to get over and score those points, which made it so much easier for their goal kickers to convert as opposed to getting the tries on the sideline. But then the Roosters kept coming back at them, so it was a contest right until the end, which made it so exciting and almost unbelievable to think an outfit like the Roosters have such quality players, and players like you can see there still haven't won a game.
Well, they've been in the grand final in the NRLW for 2 years, but they're 0-2 to begin the season. Sam, are there any glaring issues that they can fix, or is it a matter of time finding cohesion? What do you put it down to?
Well, I think it's going to be a thing of time. A lot of other players play a lot of football. Well, probably not in the last season, as of COVID sort of ruined that for everyone, but they've had seasons at club level football where they've played and they've got these combos with each other. A Roosters team, they've got a lot of the Central Coast Roosters girls that are playing for them, so I think they were hoping to depend on that, but it takes a little bit more than just a core of your group to have that cohesion, and it is a short competition. We've got a 5-week pre-season with no trial games, and then we go into play an NRLW. So I think as the season goes on in the next coming weeks,